help them. They ain't dislike Judas. It was Satan that got into Judas.
Amen.
I like that. That's good teaching.
That is good teaching, God.
Mm-hmm. It ain't that you got a problem with Jalen. Satan got into Jalen.
Right. Come on.
Some of y'all not thinking about the spirit, but trying to not like the person when it's the spirit behind the person. You gotta learn to love the person and not like the spirit. I ain't got no problem with you, but I got a problem with your lying. You, but it's something trying, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood. But there's a power that's making you lie. There's a principalities that's making you steal. There's a
come on.
Some stuff behind this. And it's not that I don't like you. Uh-huh. It's something about the enemy that got a hold of you.
Yes, Lord.
You gotta guard yourself. Somebody said, put your guard.
Put your guard up.
Now, watch this. We're not dealing with enemies.
We in house.
Yes, Lord.
And this is a part.
Watch this. Oh, fellowship. Understand, baby. That's why I say all the time, I ain't got no problem with nobody.
Mm-hmm. I heard that. Right.
Wanting to leave or got upset, I ain't got no problem. You ain't heard me say not one word about nobody.
Okay.
If I said something, you a bald face right now, and I don't like that line still. I love you, but I don't like that line still.
Tell it.
Because I realized that the person didn't do it.
Come on.
Amen.
And all God has got to do is change the spirit.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying?
No, I doubt.
Amen. Amen. So I want to deal with this text. Let's keep on going. How about that?
Verse 4.
And he went his way and communed with the chiefs, priests and captains, how he might betray unto them. He's talking about Judas, because the enemy went down into Judas. And they were glad and covenant to give him money. And he promised and sought an opportunity to betray him unto them. In the absence of the multitude.
Hold on.
What I got to do is I got to get them away from fellowship.
Come on.
Let me tell you something. Most people that get trapped are away from fellowship. Because watch this. Fellowship, you don't supposed to be going through it by yourself.
That's right.
So when you're going through it and you don't have no connection to somebody that's godlike, you end up straying from godlike thinking. Ain't nobody talking back to me. Everybody in here ought to have somebody, some friend in this church that'll bring you closer and back to God when the enemy comes to pulling on you.
I'm
not talking to anybody in this house. When you losing it and trouble is on every hand, you ought to have somebody that you can call and say, pray for me. I'm going through something.
That's good teaching.
I'm going through something. And watch this. Fellowship stabilizes your spirit, man.
Yes, God.
And y'all not under. People say, well, I ain't got to go to church to get God. I hear it right on the TV. Jethro Dollar got members, and then me, I'm a member. I ain't got to go to nobody church. But the problem is, when you're going through something, you can't call.
Come on.
Ain't nobody talking about that. When your car break down, a Clifton Dollar ain't coming to pick you up and take you to your job. You need somebody that you fellowship with. You get sick in the hospital, Clifton Dollar ain't been to Virginia Beach General yet. You need somebody that love you enough to say, I'm coming to the hospital so I can pray the enemy of depression off of you.
Yes, sir.
Because I see a spirit of depression in the room.
Yes, sir.
I act like y'all don't know what I'm talking about. But have you ever been to somebody's room that had the spirit of depression?
Yes.
Worried about dying. Worried about what was going to happen.
Come on.
You got to pray that spirit off.
Yes.
Because I'm pulling you back to God.
Yes,
Lord. And let your spirit get away.
Yes.
And see, some of you have let some of your close relatives' spirit get away from you.
Jesus.
The Holy Ghost working on my soul. Teach me, Jesus.
Yes,
some of you let folk that shouldn't have got away. You let them get away. You know why? Because you was too far.
My Jesus.
You need to get close enough so you can love your enemy.
Yes,
get close enough so you can love them that despitefully use you.
Lord, yeah.
Yes,
Lord.
You got to get them away from the people.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something, baby. The devil gonna do everything he can to get you away from good people.
Yes, sir. That's the truth.
Oh boy, that man gonna call you back now that you been trying to get yourself together. Oh, you should be trying to get yourself together. He on a text, babe. What you doing? He call you 2 weeks, 3 months. You ain't seen nothing from them, but now that watch it. Y'all don't believe this, but some of y'all know that as soon as you make up your mind, you gonna do the right thing.
Yeah.
The enemy can't pop it.
Amen.
Lord, I'm sorry for what I did, God, and now I repent, and God, I'm gonna do the right thing.
Yes. Yeah, here it comes.
If anybody experienced it, ain't afraid to tell it, lift your hand. Let me hear. But let me show you something. Watch this. That has to happen. Somebody say that has to happen. Because watch this. When you make a promise to God, it is not a promise until it's tested.
That's right. That's it.
Test. As soon as you tell God you gonna do something for him, he gonna put it to the test.
Yes, Lord.
You think you gonna make a covenant with God and it not be challenged?
That's right.
Lord, I want more faith. God gonna test your faith.
Yes, God.
Want it? I'm going to give you faith through testing your faith.
Yes, Lord. Appreciate God.
What I give faith is test your faith. The way I give patience, I'm going to test your patience.
Yeah.